well. I seen you when you were in Victor Ortiz's corner for his previous fight to the one from Berto. He looked very focused as well. What do you think happened in his fight against Andre Berto? Do you think he lost that focus? What's your take on that?
Focus? He wasn't focused. I noticed when he walked in that ring, he was not focused. You know, he was he wasn't 100% there. Because, you know, as bad as it sounds, if I would have been in that corner, I wouldn't have let him box. Honestly, I mean, yeah, he was looking good. He was moving. He was staying, keeping the distance.
He was winning the fight. A lot of people.
Yeah, he was winning the fight, but you know, to come back and make a good comeback and get yourself back in the elite level, you needed to execute Berto, and he could have done it. He could have done it, but that wasn't the proper strategy to beat Berto. You cannot box Berto. You can see Berto from the beginning just turning that shoulder. He wanted to set up the right hand, the right uppercut. What you do with Berto is take it to him from the beginning and pressure him, just the way Guerrero did and just the way Soto Caraz did. Have no respect. If you give Berto that space, that's what happens. Especially when he dropped him. When you drop Andre Berto, you cannot give him space. You cannot let him think. You gotta take it to him. Be on his face. Especially when you got power like Victor Ortiz, you cannot give anybody a chance to recover. You know, if you have him dead, keep him dead and don't let him come up.
What would you suggest the next logical step for Victor Ortiz? What would you say he does next?
I'm not the right person to suggest what he wants to do with his life. I mean, hey, he's not with me anymore. I mean, I like the kid. He's a very humble person. I mean, he's done a lot. But I just, after this loss, and the way he lost the fight, it's going to be really hard. It's gonna be a longer road for him to get to the top again. And then the sad part was that he didn't quit. You know, the referee made it seem like he did. Honestly, on the count, if you watch the count, at the count of 7, 8, he wasn't still up. So that fight should have been over. Like, the referee should have just said, it's done. He shouldn't have asked him, you want to continue? That was an extra. He shouldn't have done that. I'm sorry to say it, but if you watch the count, I mean, usually when they say 8, 9, and if you're not up completely by 9, the fight is over. By the count of 9, Victor was still not completely up. So that means 10 was next. And instead of counting 10, he just said, you want to continue, which was the fight was over. He shouldn't have been it. You know, that makes him look worse.
You know what really bothered me is when he was heading into the locker room, one of the fans took prerogative to attack him.
See, that's exactly what happens with fans, man. They want to see fights, you know. They want to see some good fights, and obviously Victor already has a bad reputation of quitting in there. He didn't quit. He was just not out there. He was hurt, you know. And people take it personal, like, oh, he quit. He didn't quit. I mean, honestly, he was hurt. He got caught with a good punch, and then he was executed. He should have done that to Andre Berto when he dropped him in the second round, but, you know, he just didn't execute.